Medicaid has helped my family make ends meet where I don't have to decide between my son's life and putting food on the table.
When I first heard about Medicaid, a family member of mine had told me about the Medicaid program, and I was very hesitant. Now that I've been on Medicaid, I realize that it's for everyone.
Doesn't matter who you are, where you're from, and how you take care of your life. If you come here or you go to any hospital, you deserve to be treated just like the next guy.
Many of us who are insured never face the dilemma of whether to take our child who's sick to the doctor or to put food on the table.
You get to the point you have to make a decision on whether you buy your food or whether you have to buy your medicine. And we made the decision that the food was more because we just buy what we need. So
Medicaid provides to our most vulnerable citizens in this state access to what many of us take for granted, and that is health.
Just imagine how you would feel if you had a young child or an elderly parent or even a husband or a wife that you could not take care of, and you had to sit there with them at home and watch them waste away.
If we did not have Medicaid, if Medicaid was not funded, if it was just yanked away, that was taken away from them, there would be needless deaths.
So when we cut Medicaid, we're not just cutting services to the poor, our aged and our disabled and our low-income families and our children. We're also cutting a $3 federal match that comes and brings in jobs and income.
Our legislators and also the general public needs to embrace Medicaid as a program that benefits the public in such a way as to make sure that we have a healthy population.
You know, everybody's going to have their moments when they need, you know, everybody gets sick. But then there are people that are trying to do good things and make a living, and they don't always make enough to have regular insurance. So, I mean, I just think that Medicaid really helps those people that really do need it.
Hello, I'm Thornton Kirby of the South Carolina Hospital Association. You see them every day at the grocery store, in church, taking their kids to school. They are your friends and neighbors, your coworkers, and even your family members. More than 700,000 South Carolinians have no health insurance, and 850,000 others depend on the state's Medicaid program when they need care.
You don't have to have lost everything to need help. I'm just an average person. I'm not any better than anybody else. I'm just an average citizen, and I think sometimes we're forgotten.